G'day, smart person. Welcome to the Physics Club. My name's Dylan. I'm a physicist from the land down under. Grab a coffee. Grab one of my Physics Club shirts below. Grab a Vegemite sandwich. Look, grab whatever you want and let's talk some physics. But before we do, I just want to say I'm as content as a cucumber. We just hit 10K subscribers. So big thanks to everyone that has subscribed. And if you haven't already, please apply some time derivative of momentum onto that subscribe button. So let's get into it. Today we're going to be watching and reacting to some more Rick and Morty because it's been great thus far. We've watched 2 or 3 episodes, loved every minute of it. I haven't shown all of it in the videos. I do watch all of the episodes. So, and I thought today we could start from the very beginning because there has been some things that I felt that I've been missing with the episodes that I've watched. So we're going to start with season 1, episode 1, pilot. And we're going to go through all of it, dare I say. So get on board, subscribe, and let's get into it. All right, here we go.
Morty, come on, you gotta come with me.
What, Rick? What's going on?
I got a surprise for
it's
you,
Morty. It's the middle of the night. What are you talking about?
Come on, I got a surprise for you. Come on, hurry up. Gotta get out of here.
Ow, you're tugging me too hard.
Come on, I got a surprise for you, Morty. Inebriated, Rick.
What do you think of this flying vehicle, Morty? I built it out of stuff I found in the garage.
Yeah, Rick, it's great. Is this the surprise?
Morty, I had to make a bomb, Morty. I had to create a bomb.
What? A bomb?
I'm gonna drop it down there. Create a whole fresh start.
That's absolutely crazy.
Come on, Morty.
Maybe I should cut that bit out. Don't come looking for me, FBI. Haven't created any bombs.
Now we're gonna go pick up your little friend Jessica.
Jessica? From my math class?
When I drop the bomb, I don't... I want you to have the thing. I'm gonna make it like a new Adam and Eve. And you're gonna be Adam.
Oh.
And Jessica's gonna be Eve.
Oh.
That's a surprise, Morty.
You can't blow up humanity!
I get what you're trying to say, Morty. Listen, I'm not... You don't gotta worry about me trying to fool around with Jessica or mess around with Jessica or anything. I'm not that kind of guy, Morty.
What are you talking about, Rick?
She's probably nothing but trouble anyways.
Neutrino bomb.
That's it, Rick! I'm taking the
get
wheel!
Get off of me, Morty!
I'm taking charge of this situation, buddy!
Oh, what's gotten into you?
Hold on. Neutrino bomb? Neutrinos are known as, like, the ghost particles. They don't really interact very often. They're very shy. So a neutrino bomb wouldn't be very effective because I can't remember the exact fact, but it's something like you could have 70 light years of lead, right? That's a shitload of lead. And if you shot a neutrino at this 70 light years of lead, it wouldn't interact once with the lead. It would fly straight through it. That's how small and weakly interacting they are. So if you made a bomb with neutrinos, it would do nothing. It would go through the Earth. Neutrinos are flying through our bodies, penetrating us, millions of them every second. They come from the sun. They come from all around, actually. It's a normal bit of matter. I believe Pauli actually was the one who predicted their existence, and they weren't discovered for 40 years or something later. And he predicted it from this radioactive decay that was violating the conservation of energy. And that's not really all G. So he predicted there must be some other form of matter that the energy is converting into. Neutrinos. Very, very cool stuff. But anyway, I may have gotten that fact wrong. So someone fact check me, please. Yeah, so it's kind of like they've just grabbed a buzzword from physics that they thought sounded super cool in front of the word bomb, like antimatter bomb. Now, you don't want to mess with that stuff. That would be bad. But neutrino bomb sounds great. Unfortunately, it wouldn't do anything.
I'll land the thing. Poor tough guy all of a sudden. Right here, Morty, on the side of the raging road here.
Oh, thank God.
You know what? That was all a test, Morty. Just an elaborate test to make you more assertive.
It was?
Sure, why not? I don't know. You know what?
Neutrino bomb.
I love that the vehicle is just an absolute mess. Have you ever seen that photo of Einstein's desk just after he died? It's a cluttered mess. Like, there's stuff everywhere, piles of stuff. It looks chaotic. And I think he once said, actually, if a cluttered desk is a sign of a cluttered mind, then what is a clean desk a sign of? It's a cool one, huh? So that mess of a car kind of relates to Einstein. It's the stereotype of a genius, right? So I think they've done well with this character.
Night again with Grandpa Rick.
What?
Dad?
What, so everyone's supposed to sleep every single night now? You realize that nighttime makes up half of all time?
Damn it!
Jerry!
Beth!
Oh my god, my parents are so loud, I want to die.
There is no God, Summer. Gotta rip that band-aid off now, you'll thank me later.
Okay, with all due respect, Rick.
Oh my god. Let's have a pause there. So, what do you guys believe in? Is there a God? Let me know down in the comments below. Atheist, religious, you're all welcome here. But me personally, maybe I should weigh in. I'm agnostic. I don't believe either way. I don't think there's enough evidence for either or. However, I do lean more towards atheist. Probably, you know, on a scale of 10, I'm probably at about an 8 atheist. And that's ultimately because the God argument just is kind of flawed, you know? It's, if you have a creator, well, who created the creator? It's just sort of this infinite regression that it's a bit of a paradox, isn't it? My honest take of religion is it's an ever-receding pocket of ignorance. So, but anyway, that's where I sit. Not quite on the fence. Let's keep watching.
What respect is due? How is my son supposed to pass his classes if you keep dragging him off for a high-concept sci-fi rigmarole?
Listen, Jerry, I don't want to overstep my bounds. How I feel about school, Jerry. It's a waste of time. Bunch of people running around, bumping into each other. Got guy up front says 2 plus 2. People in the back say 4. Then the bell rings. They give you a carton of milk and a piece of paper that says you can go take a dump or something. I mean, it's not a place for smart people, Jerry. I know that's not a popular opinion. That's my 2 cents on the issue.
I don't want to give my opinions on this. We keep going on tangents, but I will say Einstein absolutely hated school and how it's set up. Elon Musk is another advocate of we're just changing education and how we're taught. He did go into physics. He was a physics major at university. There's a lot of people out there doing very well who studied physics. So hint, hint, go study physics at university.
Get away from the windows. Now look, we're going to be dealing with some real serious stuff today. You might have heard of it. It's called math. And without it, none of us would even exist. So let's jump right in. 2 plus 2.
Jessica.
Sure. 5 plus 5.
10. Jessica.
Okay, good. It's time for the quiz. Yeah, you know what? Oh, too bad. Tough.
First. Oh, man, Rick. What is this place?
It's Dimension 35C. And it's got the perfect climate conditions for a special type of tree, Morty.
Well, I just want to say, how many dimensions are there? Could be lots. Could be all wrapped up into these tiny dimensions that we're not even aware of in string theory. Or the more complete version of string theory known as M theory today, well, the more agreed upon number currently is something like 11 or 12. So, anyway, it could be a whole bunch.
Because you're so in love with school.
All right. So what's so special about these seeds anyways?
You ask a lot of questions, Morty. Not very charismatic. It makes you kind of a underfoot figure. Just take these shoes, Morty. They're special grappling shoes. When you're wearing these things,
never be afraid to ask questions. Always ask questions. I don't agree with Rick there. Never stop questions.
Don't worry about it, Morty. Just come help me get these seeds, all right, buddy?
Sure thing, Rick.
Not that you asked, Morty, but what just happened there is I went into a future dimension with such advanced medicine that they had broken legs.
That's great. That just is kind of like what we're doing here, right? Not that you asked, but I'm just going to explain some physics. But yeah, going into the future dimension, I guess why not, right? Like, yeah, they probably have some advanced medicine, probably cured death, right? So, great idea.
The stuff was all over the place, Morty.
Wow, that's pretty crazy, Rick.
There's just one problem, Morty. One little hang-up. The dimension I visited was so advanced. They had also halted the aging process, and everyone there was young, Morty. And they had been forever. I was the only old person there, Morty. It was just like I was some sort of, you know, celebrity walking around. I was fascinating to them. There were a lot of attractive women there, Morty, and they all wanted time with me. I had a lot of fun with a lot of young ladies. But I spent so much time there, my interdimensional portal device, it's got no charge left, Morty. It's got no charge left.
What?
It's as good as garbage, Morty. It's not gonna work anymore, Morty.
Oh, jeez, Rick, that's not good. What are we gonna do? I have to be back in school right now. How are we gonna...
Tell your parents the square root of pi.
Oh, come on, Rick, you know I can't...
The square root of pi, Morty, go.
1.77245385.
Whoa!
What the hell?
Holy crap, he's right.
Morty, tell your parents the first law of thermodynamics.
The increment in the internal energy of a system is equal to the increment of heat supplied to the system? Wow! I'm so smart!
But I told the both of you, school is stupid. It's not how you learn things. Morty's a gifted child. He has a special mind. That's why he's my little helper. He's like me. He's gonna be doing great science stuff later in his life. He's too smart for school. He needs to keep hanging out and helping calm WWW Rick and Morty adventures all 100 years. Every minute, rickandmorty.com. WWW 100 times, Rick and Morty.
All right, that's the end of the first episode. I loved that. That ending was great. Rick and Morty, 100 years. I'm on board. Dylan Dance in the Physics Club, 100 years. You're on board. Let's do it. Next episode will be episode 2, so I'll see you then. Catch you guys.